Hey guys, good morning. Orbom here. I guess I'm vlogging. we're going to a League Cup today. I wanted to play some Lucario really bad. And I want to go to a tournament. I haven't been in a tournament in so long. So we're going to be playing some Lucario today at League Cup. Just woke up, just got out of the shower, looking all fresh. I'm getting clean. Look at my shirt, it's black. All right. We're going to make some eggs. We're going to get a healthy breakfast in so we can think the rest of the day. And yeah, I'll see you guys there. All right, guys, we're on our way there. I'm picking up my buddy Kate. We'll be going to the League Cup today. Sorry if there's any. By the way, using the camera. I don't have like a good phone. I have this crap thing. so we're using an actual camera. Audio's gonna be a little bit weird, so you're gonna have to deal with it. But yeah, we're going to Cards and Comics for the League Cup today. Shout out to them, by the way. What I'm thinking about doing is Cards and Comics actually does help me out every now and then by giving me free product. So I do want to give back. So as a shout out to them. I want to give away a Lucario GX box code. I am playing Lucario today at the League Cup, and we're going to see how well we do. It's my boy. I haven't played a tournament with Lucario yet, so I'm pretty hyped. So yeah, Lucario GX code. No comment question of the day. Just leave any comment, and I'll randomize it. I'll pick one of you guys. But picking up Kate, I believe she's playing Ninetales Zoroark. I think that's her thing. I love Ninetales, so I think she'll do okay if she doesn't draw poorly. That's one issue I have with Ninetales is like poor draws. But I mean, I have the same issue with Lucario too. But yeah, we're gonna go. It starts in like 45 minutes. It's like a 20-minute drive to get there. I'm just trying to think if there's anything else. I don't know. Maybe my buddy Steven will be there. If he is, I'll probably try to get him on camera as well. Regardless, wish me luck today. It's gonna be wild. Hopefully I don't draw as poorly as I've been doing on streams lately. And yeah.
Alright, I think you guys can see me. Alright, so it's a little bit windy. We're outside. It's a little crowded in there. But round one just finished. I lost. I actually ended up pairing with the person I drove here. I paired with Kate. Unfortunately, we clunked up turn one. Or turn whatever. We didn't draw a Lucario or an Ultra Ball for about five turns. So I detected and I failed all the flips. And she had a perfect game playing Ninetales. She managed to get banded Ninetales with Kukui twice. And she got double puzzle like turn whatever. That last turn, when I finally got a Lucario out, she got Kukui. And then the next turn, she had double puzzle for the Kukui again. And unfortunately, yeah, we lost that one nice and quick. She took out the first two Riolus with Zoroark. And it was weird. Like, she played down both Zoroark and Lele. So the game plan was like set for me. I knock out both Zoroarks and the Lele for game. Easy enough. But unfortunately, we flipped both tails on detect. We didn't get Lucario in enough time. When we finally got the Lucario, we knocked out a Zoroark. She knocked me out with Ninetales. I knocked out another Zoroark, and then she finished the game with Ninetales by knocking out the other Lucario as well. So it is what it is. Sometimes you just don't draw well, and sometimes your opponent draws like a lord. But hopefully we can still top cut. There's 42 players here at Cards and Comics, which is kind of wild. I think there's like 30 masters or something like that. So there's five rounds till top eight, and four more rounds to go. Hopefully we can win all the other rounds, and yeah, see you. I guess I'll keep you guys posted.
So try not to put them the little.
Hi, this is my buddy Shannon. Hi, my buddy Shannon.
she's like, you know, the owner of Cards and Comics. It's so, I love this place. But anyways, round up. We did two rounds. The first round I dunked, it was awesome. I was playing against Zoroark, they missed their Tomar Bridget, they only led with Zorua, and we got a nice dunk out here, so that's pretty cool, nice comeback from that last round. And then round three, I played against Lucario Zoroark, so easy matchup. One of those things where, like, if you can get your Rockruffs and Riolus down early game, it's pretty easy to go back as long as you don't whiff your Lucarios. Luckily, I had one in my opening hand, and yeah, so that was a pretty comfortable win. Two comfortable wins in a row. We're kind of chilling. Two more rounds left, and then we'll be done. done with today. So yeah, dude, I am hyped. Hopefully, I make top eight. But yeah, we'll see how it goes. See you guys later. All right, guys, these are my friends. This is my buddy Jared. Jared, tell us about your rounds.
First round lost.
Uh huh.
Second round lost.
Uh huh.
Third round, it gets better.
Uh-huh.
Lost.
Oh, yikes.
Actually, only got one prize card on the last game.
Okay, so. tell us about your tournament.
I keep winning.
Just tell us what you're playing.
I'm well.
No. Okay.
The magician never reveals the secret.
Yeah. So, like, you know, definitely not playing hoop or anything. How about you, Kate? This is the girl. I drove here. I'm going to zoom in real close to her face. This is the girl I drove here. She body bagged me with the perfect Nine Tails game while I was
and
stuck.
And then the second two games.
All right, guys. Hold on. I gotta make sure I look good.
All right.
We're waiting for this girl. Hey, say hi.
Joe.
Daisy. Daisy, say hi.
Hi. Daisy.
All right, cool. We're waiting on this game because Daisy's a really slow player. Just kidding.
Not me, really.
Yeah. All right, guys. Played a game against Duskmane Garb. Duskmane Garb is so good, bro. I whiffed. Ooh, it's really windy. All right, guys. 3-1. Yeah, we're back in business. I think we can ID the next round, and then we can do top 8. Played against Duskmane Garb. Really close game. He was looking for his energy switch, and it was prized, which sucks. But it was real close. It was 2-1 prizes. well, the game was started pretty decently for me, although he got Garb real early, and I couldn't find any blowers for the life of me, bro. I didn't find blowers until like the last two turns of the game when I really needed them. Luckily enough, I got them at the right time, but those Garbs are annoying. Can't use my Lycanroc, can't use my Octillery. But I started the game with a Lucario, able to knock out a Trubbish, because he had a Trubbish out. I saw that he was playing unit energies because he mulliganed like twice, I think. So I saw he was playing unit energies, so I knocked out the Trubbishes as soon as I could. I knocked out enough Trubbishes to where he couldn't play his Trash Lanch anymore, so he didn't have Trash Lanch as an option, which was good, because I'm assuming the deck doesn't play stretchers. A lot of these decks don't play stretchers. And the only issue was the Garbotoxin. So he had one last Trubbish, which he evolved to Garbotoxin and turned off my Lycanroc's ability, so I couldn't be able to knock him out easily. I kept trying to knock out that Solgaleo Prism, but I kept whiffing the things I needed to knock it out. So that was unfortunate, but it doesn't matter because we ended up GXing. We landed a clutch strong energy choice band to GX with Lycanroc to knock out a fully set up Duskmane before it attacked. And the next turn, I knocked out a Lele at some point with a Guzma, and then I got Guzma for game because he wasn't able to end me. So that was pretty dope. Happy about that win. That one had me nervous. It's really dark, bro. Like, you can't even see me. Yo, the light. I'm pretty hyped. I think I'm gonna ID the next round, which means I think we're in top 8. But yeah, I'll let you guys know how the results go later. Peace. Hey guys, I'm done. We lost in top 8. We played against Vikabulu. And unfortunately, I couldn't get out of that situation. Game one, I played with no Lele and no Octillery, because both the Lele, I think no. Game one was when my Remoraid was priced. So we had one Lele in the deck, of course, as you guys know, Lucario Lycan. One Lele in the deck, we had one Lele prize and the Remoraid prize, game one. And after I played my Sycamore, didn't find any draw spores after that. So I was detecting and failing every roll but one. And eventually he just took it. I could never find a combination of Strong Energy, Choice Band, and Regirock to knock out a Bulu. And even whenever I could potentially find it, it was too late in the game, and he just took two more knockouts, and that was game. So, unfortunately, game one was that way. Game two was no better, unfortunately. The Lele was prized again. So, once again, no more Ultra Balling for draw supporters. And this time, the Octillery was prized. So, even though I got Remoraid down, I couldn't find the Octillery. No draw support. Means no combo, means nothing for me. And my opponent got like Turmoil Vikavolt both games, Turmoil Bridget, Turmoil Vikavolt. It is what it is, like that's whatever. I don't care that he sets up. The problem with Lucario is that Lucario can pretty much beat any matchup because it's really aggressive and really fast. And it can hit 180, just put down a Regirock, strong energy choice band, easy enough. It's not that hard. It's just a matter of like, you know, drawing. Which is unfortunate because, you know, no Lele. So looks like we lost the top 8, but we made top 8. It's been like about 2 years since I've been to a League Cup, so I guess that's pretty cool that we made top 8 with Lucario no less. That's pretty dope. Yeah, about 30 people. I don't know. I might do like, probably not actually. We'll see. I might play Lucario again on stream. I might try to play around, maybe add a second Lele, because apparently I need one, even though I've been fine with just one these past couple tournaments, but it is what it is. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Don't forget to drop a like. Remember that we are doing a Lucario GX giveaway, so remember to leave a comment. And yeah, hey guys, we're back. I'm not gonna bother putting background music or anything like that here. We're just gonna end off this vlog. Hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. It's my first one ever on the channel, so let me know if you guys want more. Let me know if you guys liked it. Let me know ways I can do this better. You know, it's the first time experience, so we're just trying to grow, learn how it all, you know how it is. This is the deck list if you guys are interested. Overall, the deck ran really well. I just had tough times dealing with prizes, I think prizes are like my biggest issue, right? I do, after this tournament, right, I played this deck with one Lele for the longest time. I've won multiple league challenges, small tournaments like that here and there, with little to no issue playing this deck. I've been testing this deck since Lucario was released, as you guys know. If you guys follow me on Twitch, twitch.tv/ABOrbom, you know that we play this deck all the time, taking crazy win streaks. It's so much fun. It's my favorite deck to play right now. Definitely a deck I had the most experience with. And after a while, I did take out a Lele because I definitely didn't need it. I'm of the belief that if you don't play Bridget, you don't really care about turn one Lele. But I feel like I might have to play a fourth Cynthia or a second Lele. I'm more likely to play a fourth Cynthia, but I can definitely see the argument to play a second Lele. Overall, though, the deck ran really fun. The only thing I do want to put in is either a fourth Cynthia or a second Lele to help me just draw these situations. I'm actually probably going to be the second Lele actually over the fourth Cynthia. I just don't know what I'd cut. I play my three Regirox to help me deal with Sylveon Mill, since Sylveon Mill is really popular right now. Because, as you can see, Choice Band, Strong Energy with a with three Regirox down means we Oko Sylveon, which is kind of important. So that's why I am playing the three Regirox, and I can't play less because Sylveon will body back you otherwise. I don't think there's much else for me to talk about, though. I hope you guys enjoyed the vlog. Remember, we are doing that Lucario GX code giveaway, so just leave any comment. Let me know what you guys think. Let me know what your favorite deck is to play right now. Let me know how you did it at a League Challenge or League Cup yourself recently. Anything you guys want, let me know in the comments. I'll go ahead. I respond to all comments. I like all comments. Don't worry about it. So I'll check that out, and then we'll do that Lucario GX giveaway. I'll randomize it, and I'll give it to one of you guys. So don't worry about that. Overall, it was a lot of fun. It's the next day for me. I'm trying to get this up by Monday. Hopefully, it's up by Monday. I don't know what I'm going to do with a thumbnail. Oh, boy. oh, well, whatever. I'll see you guys next time. Hopefully. Oh, yeah. I'm going to have an updated version of this deck with Forbidden Light. We're playing Diancie. We're playing Buzzwole. That's really the only difference in this deck compared to, like, beforehand. Maybe I can cut out. Maybe I can just make the deck a little bit more consistent with that. With Diancie Prism in the deck now, who knows, we'll see what happens. But we should have that versus Alternate Krozma, probably not the next video, but the video afterwards. I do have a Glaceon video I want you guys to see as well with the new set. But regardless, drop a like on the video if you haven't already, subscribe, share, all that good jazz. Thank you guys for hanging out. I'll see you guys next time. Peace.